Okay, everybody, welcome to Football Focus UAE, and it's In Conversation again. Today we're not interviewing a football player, we're interviewing a very, very successful manager. His name is, I have to get this right, Gjoko Hadžievski. He's the manager of the Emirates Football Club. He has been for two seasons, but Iain's going to tell us a little bit about him.
Yeah, he's a very, very illustrious career. He's been coaching or managing for 33 years across Europe, Japan, Macedonia,
Saudi Arabia,
here with Hatta, Al Dhafra, and he's ended up here with the Emirates Club. And last season, they went nearly unbeaten. They were one game away from...
One point away from winning
the league and going into the Arabian Gulf League until, unfortunately, COVID hit. And then this year, they've come back, they've done it all again, and they finished second. And next season they'll be in the Arabian Gulf League where they belong.
Yeah, so it's what we would like to know, Iain and I, when we're looking forward to this interview, because we want to know how he did it here.
Yeah.
How did he manage to motivate when you think of Shabab Al-Athli, Sharjah? Where are they doing? Look at England, Liverpool.
Exactly.
Obviously, COVID's affected them. We want to know, as a manager, Iain, we know already how players feel about playing with no fans all season. We want to know what a manager feels about playing all season and motivating his players. So we're in for a really interesting interview in conversation with the manager of the Emirates Club. And we also have asked him to give some advice to our students and football coaches who watch our show.
That's it.
So we're going to have a chat with him.
Make sure you listen carefully and take it all on board.
Let's go meet him. Okay, everybody, welcome to Football Focus UAE. And again, we have a special episode today. It's In Conversation with Mr. Hadžievski. Is that right?
Exactly.
Hadžievski. And excuse my pronunciation,
not very good. No.
We'd like to welcome, he's the manager of the Emirates Football Club, who's just been newly promoted to the UAE Pro League. As you know, my name's Tony, this is Iain, and we'd like to say thank you very much for allowing us to interview with you today. It's a real pleasure. And I have to say, maybe I shouldn't say this, but the Emirates Club is my club. It's a club I follow. I'm really pleased.
Pleasure.
When I heard the news.
You should be happy now.
Yes. Yes, I'm very, very happy. But again, thank you for meeting us today. And we'll start off, Iain. Wanted to ask you a particular question. I'll let Iain start off. Is that so?
It was more about your journey. Why did you become a manager? What inspired you to become a manager?
Long story. Because I started to be manager in 1988 in January. Yeah. I mean, 32 years. And I am...
Yes, I've seen you. It's a very...
Almost 35 years professional coach.
It's all
maybe over. 1,000 games in my career.
Wow.
And I work enough. Maybe 10 countries out of Macedonia. The time that when I started to coach, to be coach, we were in, include Yugoslavia, one of the best countries in the world.
Mm-hmm.
In every, how can I say, qualification, like strong country, like nice life in the country, passport free in all the world, and the championship, one of the best in Europe. You know how many players from Croatia, Serbia, Bosnia.
It's fantastic.
It's all the best club in Europe. And was pleasure for me to be 1999, I become president of the coaching organization in Yugoslavia. Last 2 years of Yugoslavia before we divided in six countries. And I know information that Yugoslavia has at that time 200 coaches who were working, 200 coaches who were working abroad.
Right.
Wow. And we have many coaches in big clubs like Viljanic and Boškov and Antic, three coach who was in Real Madrid coach, Barcelona, Antic also, Atletico Madrid.
It's very impressive.
Many impressive. Big name.
But why did you decide to become
I was,
what was you thinking?
I was from the time I know for myself, 5 years, maybe 4 or 5 years, my father was a football coach. I was every day in the field. And then he explained to me, introduced to me the best players in the world, our country.
Nice.
Then I started to follow this. And football was more stronger than anything in me.
It was in your blood.
In my blood, believe me. I am from my first age that I start to to remember everything. I'm in the football, I like a young guy, I cry watching the games. You are from England. I remember when I watched the game, final game in 1996, England-Germany, 3-2.
Yeah.
It hurts this goal, yeah. You know. And then, this is beginning of my learning the players, the clubs, football. I play from my 16 years till my 28. Actually, more 2 years later, I start to be coach, and then I play more two years. Like 14 years I played.
So you've been a footballer and
football,
a coach.
Football in my country. And I, because I finished sport university, logically was to find myself in football, like coach. Mm. And then I have always my philosophy in the football. I was midfield, libero, defender, playmaker sometime. You know, and I read the game. Mm-hmm. And when I put all together with the methodology of training, especially football training,
sure.
Then I become to think a little bit more serious in all the things. And by the way, my starting, I was 4 years in youth category, and then I start to be professional coach with my 29 years, I become, no, 32, 32, 1988, January. I become first coach in Yugoslavian Professional League. And then, yeah. Then
very young age as well.
Yeah, first year of success, more 2 years success, 3 years was consecutive in my club with very good result, and then best Macedonian club bring me there where I made best my result in history. I was 5-time champion with Vardar Macedonian best club,
wow.
2-time cup winner, and 1 time I bring them from second division in Yugoslavia in first division in Yugoslavia.
I've seen you've been quite successful all over the world whenever you've been.
Many times. I was champion with Baku, Azerbaijan. Mm. I take national team of Azerbaijan. After 2 months, they give me national team together with Baku, champion.
Baku. You've even done it in Japan. I saw you.
I was in Júbilo, one of the best clubs in Japan.
Yeah, I saw
Júbilo is 2-time Asian championship and 3-time champion Japan. I play final game. Runner-up 2000 with Júbilo. We play only one game against Hilal in Riyadh in Saudi Arabia. Mm. Was Jordanescu coach of Hilal. We lost the game by golden goal 3-2.
Yeah.
Till final we don't receive no one goal. We win all the team without receiving no one goal. We don't draw. All win till final game. But we play only one game on the field of home team of the Hilal.
Yeah.
And we have advantage in 89 minutes, 2-1 for us. Last minute they scored 2-2, and then with golden goal, they win 3-2. But I coming final game in Champions League, I take Super Cup in Japan same years against Nagoya in Tokyo full stadium, and I finish third place in the championship. We were before semi-final in Riyadh game, we were in first position. When we're coming back from the Asian Championship, we lost, we played a draw and we lost points there, and we lose first position. But this was because of the
two
sides, you know, and traveling from Riyadh, coming back, you know, this moment. But club proposed 3 or 1 year. I said it was first time for me go far away from Macedonia, too much far away Japan. I didn't know mentality, lifestyle.
Very different.
Yeah, very different. Totally different. But however, I spent very nice time, very
sure
nice memory, because in this club like Júbilo, I did maybe two European coaches.
Yeah.
No,
you mentioned before about your coaching methodology and philosophy. What is your footballing philosophy? How do you want your teams to play?
Normally, this philosophy always develop. Depends of time, model of modern football in the world.
It's different today. It's a high-pressing game.
For example, I start like usually everybody played at the time for 4-3-3 or 4-4-2. Then I was one of the first in Yugoslavia. By the way, I was second B national, first coach of B national team Yugoslavia. After A national team, I was 4 years in the technical staff in Yugoslavian Federation. And as a president of coaching organization, which I was inside in the group of the coaches who discussed about the changing of system playing. Mm-hmm. If you remember, that time was Ajax with Rinus Michels.
Yeah.
They started to play total football with 3-5-2, and me and the national coach, Ivica Osim, who is big name in Yugoslavian football, and by the way, he was national coach of Japan.
Yeah.
And very
successful.
Successful, very good coach. One of the best. He was in 1990 with Yugoslavia, fifth in World Cup in Italy.
Yeah, yeah.
With the Šuker, with Stojković, with Savicevic, with all this. No, this Bulgaria.
Oh, Bulgaria.
Bulgaria 1998 in USA. Mm. They were. And I have story for that because that time I was coaching CSKA Sofia.
Oh, okay.
One of the first time. Yes, yes.
When they were in
David Mariani, World Cup for them.
Yeah, and they're my friend. I was there that time. That means we start to play 3-5-2 first in Yugoslavia.
Mm.
And when we discussed in the meeting in the coaching organization, and they say we should follow the many coaches. We should follow the news in the football, see 3-5-2 is modern now in the football. I say, okay, let's play. I play with my team 3-5-2. I start to play. Let's play. Maybe risk, you know.
Yeah.
This is a risk. 3-5-2 is a system that you should make very good organization. Otherwise, back side is this wing side is open.
Yeah, exposed.
You
know?
But if you have discipline inside the game, can be very offensive system. And I remember 1983. I go in CSKA Sofia. CSKA Sofia, one of the biggest club in history in Bulgaria. Club with the best stars in Bulgarian football, and I was 1993 first international club, first international coach in Bulgarian football.
Mm.
Young, 38 years.
Wow.
And with CSKA, I start to play 3-5-2. I have a reaction from the beginning, everybody say, oh, this system, we don't know. Then methodology, I start to use fitness.
Mm.
Before my coming in Bulgaria, but his teacher from the school, sport teacher, what's this, fitness, this, that. But after
you change.
6 months, all the clubs start to play 3-5-2 in the league. You know, this was my success, and till now, all these years, I have very close connection with Bulgarian players, football, and all this.
But what's bring you to the Emirates club now, then?
Emirates Club.
What's your major success? Because you think you went through that COVID, you were 1 point away from winning the league.
Yeah.
And then cancelled.
Yeah, this was.
And then now you've managed to do it again. What's your secret to your success? How did you do that?
2016 in Hatta.
Hmm. Yes, I saw that.
Yeah, and this was first my year before I was 3.5 years in Saudi Arabia. I working in Super League in Saudi Arabia 3 years.
Uh-huh.
I was coach in Najran, Town, and Katsia. And then after that, I coming first club in Hatta.
And then Al Dafra.
And Dafra later, yeah. And Hatta was beginning of season with, I suppose that's why they changed coach. They want to change a little bit more, how can they successful team?
Yeah.
Team in cup game they lost many games, and the champion first 2 games they have 1 point. And then I come, 3 games, 3 win, 9 points in first 3 games. But till end of the championship, we keep positive result. And 1 month before end of the championship, we stay in the league.
Mm.
This is my first experience here. I learned the clubs, players, mentality, organization.
Mm-hmm.
Then, beginning of second year, I don't know, was some misunderstanding. First three games we have very strong game, especially with Achli and Alain.
It's
difficult to win this game.
Yeah.
Okay, they decide to change technical stuff. Then I go home after 3 months. Dafra was last position in the same championship, second year. Dafra was in last position. We coming in January from last position. We saved them with my staff, with my assistant coach.
You saved them from relegation.
We saved them. Yes, we saved them in the league. They were 4 months without winning game from September to January. No one winning game.
Wow.
Yeah, but I think we make good job also there. And then also they decide to take another staff. Like
they like to do that here in the UAE.
Okay, this is what I can do, this destiny sometime. And after 1.5 years, one and a half years, something like this, coming invitation from Emirates Club. Beginning of, this was 7 days before start league.
Wow.
This is without preparation.
Pre-season we come.
Pre-season, finish everything. Like, we're coming Monday, Sunday start first game in championship.
And potentially you're changing the formation, you're changing the personnel.
Yeah, everything.
So what's your secret to success, especially after COVID? You mean you won the league, then you got cancelled, then you had to do it all again.
We made very good result these first years.
Fantastic.
Very quickly. And I think that I don't remember if some team win 10 consecutive game in last year in championship.
Yeah, it was very impressive. You were five games and 1 point you needed.
We
to
have
promoted.
Last four games, we need only, and we have 2 games home, 2 away, we need only 1 point sufficient to be in the league. And we expect that we can go, but federation decide that league must be same 14 Super League, not 16. If you go there without to fell down nobody from there, league with 16 maybe is different for them, more complicated. And was disappointed for us, really disappointed, because we deserve with our games, without result, everything is
very
big difference.
Mm.
We were 10 points from third, 7 points from Hisan.
Yeah, of course, there was no way he was
10 points from third position. And then, you know, one period, and then break in March. In March was very strange, you know, 2019.
Was it difficult this season to motivate the players? Obviously, you came so close last season. Then to have to start again.
So how did you do it?
How do we do? First, we have competition mentality. This winning mentality. We won many games.
Yeah.
Atmosphere was positive.
Yeah.
Organization inside. We club decide to continue in same team because was
so
everything okay. And we start early, beginning of July. Mm-hmm. We starting to when federation give green light for.
Pre-season
with special protocol.
Yeah.
We start to follow this protocol with groups from the beginning, not all together. We follow everything. I must say in this moment now that in our club, our manager Khalil Altaun, Al Tawul, and Adil, like secretary and president. Mohamed Shamsi, they are very strict with protocol federation.
Yeah. That's good to hear.
We follow, and all of us, this is, you know, I think very, how can I say, good point of everybody in the club, like players, like staff, that maybe we have a couple of 3-4 players in 1 year positive in COVID.
I think it shows like good discipline from everybody.
Very disciplined. We don't move. We stay.
To keep
we don't,
it to
we don't risk.
Three,
we don't risk. Yeah. We follow all this protocol, and believe me, we have only individual, not groups.
Mm.
One, then one like this.
It's very good to keep it such a minimum.
We keep.
To keep
without that problem.
Winning mentality with the players is very good. But what about new season?
We have very, very good atmosphere inside. Mm. Very disciplined players. Then we started working very early. We don't looking for new team. We have team.
Yeah.
Just we put couple of position
better.
Yeah. Strengthen the team.
Yeah, and we go because of COVID, nobody don't move out of the country. We decide to make preparation here. We were in Dubai, in
the
Jabal Ali Hotel.
Yeah.
Perfect condition we have there.
Good football pitches out there.
Yeah, services. Perfect pitches, hotel, and we started to make good preparation. And I don't know for another team, but we play very strong games. We played first game with Ahli, 18 August. Then every 3-4 games we have. Ahli, Nasser, Jezira, Sharjah, who was 5-6 team we have Hatta one game. Yeah.
Calva, did you play Calva?
With Calva we played last game before start of the season. We won in Calva 2-1.
Yeah.
It was very strong games for us. Then we make maybe more early than usually our form, even we don't know when start the championship, but we were ready all the time.
Yeah.
And then coming our cup games.
I saw that as well, you did very well.
And there we were very successful.
Yeah, very.
3-2.
And you lost to Shabab Al-Atli.
Yes, last game decide between us and Bataya, we won Bataya away.
Yeah.
And we finished without losing game of this 5 game in the first position. Then we won Kalba with extra time here. And then we played perfect game with Ahli there in
unlucky to lose.
We lost 2-0, but game was very tough.
We could have gone anyway as well.
One moment that they canceled our goal with 4 minutes VAR.
Yes.
4 minutes VAR. That means that's very, I don't know, strange, but okay.
So it was a good pre-season then, because
very good,
very strong, prepared you well.
Start championship.
The championship.
First game, 3 winning game.
Yeah, well, you've only lost once all season.
And then, one last year, one this year, one.
Fantastic.
And then, December was, for 25 days, we played 6 games.
Did you have a lot of draws in them games?
No, after that.
Oh, it was after that.
That's been till 26 was really Championship Cup, and
pretty brutal team schedule.
Then team a little bit different. Then our style playing we changing because Tommy, who was striker, classical striker, we play with two classical strikers.
Yeah.
He go, and we bring after him Yasin from Dafra, you know. And in December, beginning of January, was Acosta, our best scorer in the team 2 years.
Yeah.
He was positive in the corona.
Oh,
and then we lost 2 forward.
Yeah.
We were not enough
strong.
And everybody against us play with strong defense.
Because they'll play compact.
Yeah.
They don't give you any room.
Yeah. And
hence the draws.
Dance happened. We were in all the game better.
Yeah.
And every game we play home away, we were better than our opponents.
But missing the two strikers. A lot of the time when you're a team who's towards the top of the league, you play against other teams, they come defensively. I said they play pack,
yes.
They don't give you any room.
Yes.
And it's
yes,
so
yes,
difficult
yes.
to break down.
Yeah, that's why
losing a striker.
And 3 games that we lost, like we lost points like draw, was last minutes from corner.
Yeah.
If you imagine in our, this in the stadium, left side of the goal, in same goal, 3 corner, 3 different game.
Yeah.
Last means we lost 6 points. Believe me.
Must be pulling your hair out.
But when you watch the game, could be 3-1, 4-1 for us game. Let's come in 1-1 or 2-2. And game who decide for best in this league, for example, with Oroba, respecting for all the results that they do, you know, to make 12 winning games from 14 games last is really impressive and difficult to be
to match that,
same, you know. But I must say that we were much better in this game. We have 1-0, nothing dangerous from side of Oroba. Also, they play defense. We keep everything. We have chance for 2-3 chances, very good chance for 2-0. And then 92 minutes corner,
1-1.
And this was, I think, this moment when we lose first position with them. But if we follow all the result and play start playing of the team, we were consecutive in all these 2 years superior in the games.
That's good team. But time permitting, what about the new season? You're now in the Pro League for the new season. Are you going to do anything different? Are you going to change anything?
First, all of us.
The fans want to know.
We have some. But no, that's serious. But officially, I have not an extension in the contract. We should finish. Wait to finish last game, Saturday against Masfuti play. Mm-hmm. After game, I hope that we can sit with the club. I hope that we can continue also, but now is decision of the club to do this. And if I stay normally, you know, all the every coach have advantage when you continue
in the same team. You've got that continuity.
You know the players, you know possibility of them. You know what is weeks.
Yeah.
Point of
you know how to motivate them, how to get the best out of them.
Yes,
as you've done for two seasons.
Yes. And this, however, is an advantage for a coach, for the players. And I must say one more time, I'm very blessed and thankful that I have wonderful atmosphere. No one
it's
is
a lovely club here.
In 2 years, no one moments bad. Believe me.
That's no one moments.
We are like family. And together with not only this, I'm type of the coach who give free to the all staff, this is medical staff or the administration or this.
You kind of know everybody.
Everybody work on job without press, without nothing. Just we are focused in the game, in the field, in the work, in the progress with our players. I think maybe in the end I want to say that you have many different type of the coaches, but somebody is manager coach, you know, somebody is like competition. Yes, everybody wants to be competition, everybody is competition, but everybody think about the result, you know. I am coach who want to go for result, but from another side, to build the best form of the players game, own game, own style of game.
So you want to see them develop and improve as players.
Yes.
What about, we wanted to ask you, Mr. Gjokica, what about playing, we've asked players, we've interviewed many players and asked them what it's like playing under these COVID-19 conditions. You know, you've had a season where you've had no fans. And the players have given their opinion. What's it like as a manager having no fans in the stadium?
Big handicap. Handicap.
I could imagine.
Handicap. Football without...
We say they're the 12th player.
Yeah. Fans. Football without fans is...
Without being difficult as a manager?
Difficult. Not difficult, but... Different. Not same. Not same pressure.
The atmosphere must be different.
We play for the...
Fans.
Expected as well. Fans. You know, first year, when we play with fans, they are happy again. They follow us outside, here. But this year, it was nothing. You don't know, you play at home, away, this is same. And the empty stadium, you know, how can I say? Again, I can say, everybody of us want to prove to the people that you do good job.
They
play good. They want to celebrate goal with us.
Is it hard for you to get motivated and to motivate your players when you turn up and the guys go on the pitch and there's no fans? Is it difficult to keep them motivated and keep their desire?
And this moment, I keep focus in the target win the game and our playing style. I don't speak about the this kind, you know.
So you have a clear game plan, clear focus.
We think about Shabab today, we should think about this part of our game must be better. In this, making the advantage inside, we must do better. The covering defense, covering between players, or combination between attack must be better, and we practice in the training. And again, we expect to do better. Every game to be better, then this is way that you are optimistic that next period will be better.
Yeah.
If you make progress, that means you are in good way. But if you play always same, it's not progress.
Yeah. Right?
Mm-hmm. We've got to time permitted, because I know you've got to, sorry to interrupt you. But Iain wanted to ask about, what advice was it, Iain? You've got a good question about our students.
Well, we have a lot of young students watch the game. What advice would you give to them on maybe becoming a manager, or even just becoming a professional footballer?
What advice would we've got, by the way, this goes out to the Ministry of Education,
to the fans,
young people watching this. What advice would you give them?
What attributes do you look for in a player?
You know, because I am one examen who lived with football for my burning, when I was born, you know.
And you were born with a football in your hands.
But I know many people who want to be coach. Everybody want to be in this position, which is more sweet position, nicest position. From another side, is too much difficult. You put a mountain in your plate, you know, with pressure. And they want to be, but you should be belong in the football, not only to want to be coach.
Yeah.
That means it's best way if you feel football, if you, like player, if you feel football, if you understand position of the players. Then if you play football, then like coach in the dojo for your working, you can make progress of each player because you know what in the field. Sometimes you cannot be theoretically like I want to play like Messi or Ronaldo. Okay, you want to be, but this is not the same exam, you know. Then you should feel which possibility of every player to make good estimation, to give him best position for him. That's why it's very important in the position of coach, you should be like good in practice, good in education, because you cannot be coach if you don't know methodology of working.
Yeah.
Some law, science law in our work, you know.
Yeah.
It's not just put training around today 1 hour.
Yes,
but run.
Yeah.
I must know in every moment which is this criterion for physical preparation. You have 4 part. Not only physical preparation is one.
Yeah.
Physical is power. Is basic endurance, it's speed endurance, it's sprint, you know, all these parts you should complete with balance, then technical, tactical training. And that's why I want to say that you should have this knowledge in you. And from, finally, like personality, you should be positive. You must like the players. You must be like father for them, or brother if he's younger. You must love them. You must understand them, you know,
to be successful.
And all
to get
these
the best.
Points in one person is difficult to find. You know,
listen carefully, students.
Yeah. This last your question, I have examined because I am grandfather of two grandchild, this boy twins with 4.5 years, and I have one grandson who is. Maybe best talent in my country. He is with 17 years in best our club in first team now, yes. National teams generation.
He played. Congratulations.
And I worked with him with his 2 years, you know. Now, grandchild, this grandsons with 4.5 years. The first important is that the parents want to introduce to them football.
Okay.
They must watch football. You cannot play game every day and go just make training. They must learn the best player, teams. I must tell you, my grandchild, they know every time Champions League team, just they see in the TV, they say this is Chelsea, this is Arsenal, this is Real Madrid or Barcelona. You know, because parents must introduce them. They must put them to love the football, you know.
So the responsibility on
them
as well.
Follow best player. How Ronaldo play, how Messi play, how another players play, you know. And then watching, the football coming inside of you.
So they need, I think they need it in their soul. So they need to love the game.
Love the game, love the football. Mm. They need to watch the parents who want that own child to be football players. They must stay with them watching, not movie, football, only football they must watch. I say to my daughter, my son-in-law, I say, if I see movie in the TV, I can block TV. You can watch only football, you know. They must be football players, you know.
That's good.
Yes. This kind of
so I think live and breathe football.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, well, look, thank you. Thank you for listening. And what we, Iain and I, and no doubt your fans, we wish you all the success in the future. And we wish the Emirates Club all the success as well. They've been really good to us, haven't they? And especially Adele, who's always taking care of us. And thank you for today, Mr. Hadžievski.
For you.
It's a real privilege and honor for us to meet you.
Honor for me also. I hope that I can meet you again.
Inshallah, yes. As I say.
And we can speak for
And thank you everybody for listening, and thanks to the Emirates Club again, to Adele who's organised this, and it's a real pleasure.
I just delayed it a bit.
No, it's no problem at all. Thank you.